Let's have a look how easy it is to use Flexel 4.NET in server-side Blazor web applications. The standard template when you create a new Blazor web application with Visual Studio 2019 contains a fetch data page. This data page retrieves data from a fictitious weather data service listing temperatures in Celsius and Fahrenheit for dates. We will use this weather service to add a chart. This chart will be generated using Flexel 4.NET. The chart will not be loaded as a plugin or as a subpage. No, it will be generated as a vector image. So that chart is actually rendered by your web browser as a vector image. Let's get started. We create a new project using File, New Project, and we create a Blazor app. We name it Flexel Server-Side Demo. And after clicking Create, we can select the Blazor server app. Make sure that .NET 5.0 is selected and Configure for HTTPS, for simplicity reasons, is disabled. Before we can continue, we need to add Flexel to the .NET project. In Visual Studio, this is pretty easy using the NuGet Package Manager. Right-click the project, select Manage NuGet Packages, go to Browse, and in case you install Flexel on your system, you will have the package source flexel.tmssoftware.com. Click in here, select TMS Flexel, install, OK, and accept the license agreement, and that's it. Checking under Dependencies, Packages, you should see Flexel added to your project. Let's have a look at the project that is created by the template. As you can see, we have several pages which are provided by default, including fetch data, which contains, as you can see here, a table with a date, temperature in Celsius, temperature in Fahrenheit, and a summary that explains what kind of weather to expect on that day. The data is being extracted from a fictitious weather service, which you find here in data, weatherforecastservice.cs. As you can see, it's not really accessing a web service of any sort. It's just random data. Going over here to weatherforecast.cs, you see the actual entity. An array of this is being shown inside of the table. So you have the property values, date, temperature Celsius, temperature Fahrenheit, and summary. Going over to the Razor page, you can see right here that here you see the data binding to these properties. The data is loaded asynchronously using the forecast service, right here. You will end up with an array of weather forecast items. This is exactly where we will add the handling of the chart. We will add the chart to the table. In order to do that, we need to add a couple of namespaces into our page. Using Flexel Core, using Flexel.txt XLS adapter, and we're going to generate the vector image using the reporting engine of Flexel. So we add Flexel report, and finally we use system.txt for the string type that we're going to use inside of this page. And this is exactly the addition we need to make to the table. Below the table, we're going to add the chart. For that, we add a new paragraph with the phtml tag, and our property is going to be named temp.svg. However, we want this property to be interpreted by the web browser. So what we need to do, we need to cast it to a so-called markup string. With this typecast, the data inside of temp.svg is being interpreted by the web browser, and if it is a vector image, the browser is going to show a vector image. Right now, this cast is incomplete. The at sign has to refer to this whole expression, and then it will be fine. Temp.svg, of course, is not declared yet, because temp.svg, as I said before, is going to be our image. So that is going to be a string, so we can actually declare that in the code. So we add the declaration for temp.svg, private string temp SVG. Be certain to put it right into the code and not underneath the uninitialized async method. And this method is being executed as soon as the page has been initialized. So we can put the code to generate the chart there as well. Remember, this is all asynchronous. That means we need to provide another method that is able to be executed right away. So this actually can be done with another await keyword. So await task.run. And this is where we are going to use a lambda expression. And here we are going to call the Flexel methods. And Flexel is based on XLS file classes or instances, which we can create with new XLS file. And here we are actually going to load a template, which I'm going to build next. And the template is going to be in the directory app data, and then temperature.xlsx. That's going to be the file name that we're going to use for the template. And then we can use the reporting engine, but of course, in order to use the reporting engine, we need to create a report instance. Everything can be done using Flexel report. So let's rep equals new Flexel report. And the parameter that we're going to use is true that we allow overwriting of files. With that in mind, we can then add the data to the report. So we do xls rep.addTable. What is going to be our table? Well, we need a name, weather. And then we can provide a data structure of some sort. We can provide, as you see here in the IntelliSense, a system data data table, but an array is just fine, an array of object instances. So we're going to provide forecasts as the table weather. So when we go into the report in Excel, we can use the forecast items to reference the different items in the report. So for example, to reference something in the Excel template, we would write weather dot, and then looking at the weather forecast item, weather dot date, weather dot temperature C, and so on. That's what we would use in order to access each item inside of Excel. And then of course we need to run the report. And here we link the file to the report, run XLS. So the result of the report generation will be put in this XLS file. And at the same time, of course, we also provide the template that way. The last step is to extract the chart from the report or from the Excel sheet into the temp SVG variable. So let's make that a comment, extract chart into temp SVG. That is the final step. I'm going to leave that open. So far, this is all we need to do code-wise in our server application. That's it. There's one more line in order to extract the chart, but everything else is now Flexel using an Excel template, using Excel, and all the charting and everything can be configured using Excel and not in code. And that is what makes Flexel such a great product. So we start Excel and we start with a blank workbook. And what I will add is a few dummy values so we know which data structure to show. So for example, on December 1st, 2020, it was 80 degree Fahrenheit, or let's say 82 degree Fahrenheit, 28. And on the 2nd, 2020, it was say 90, which is around 32, whatever in Celsius. This is the data representation that we want to create a chart of. So we select this range and then include a chart. Let's take a simple bar chart with 2D columns like this. So this is the chart based on these values. And now we can name it. We can name it temperatures. But the most important thing is this chart has a name. Right now it's shot one, and we are going to name it temperature chart. This way we can access the chart inside of the Excel sheet from code. So we just need this name, and then we have access to this chart. And of course you will be able to format the series, and you will be able to add annotations, stuff like that, but let's do that later. Let's focus on how to get the data into the actual sheet. And for that, we will need to add placeholders that FlexCell is going to replace with the actual data. If you look at the FlexCell documentation, you can write weather dot why weather. Well, if you look at the C# code, we named the table weather. And then what comes after the dot is determined here. So we have date, temperature C, and temperature F. So that we then use weather dot date. That is the first one. And here we use weather dot temperature C or temperature F. And here we do for Fahrenheit. And here we do weather dot temperature C for the Celsius values. And we can remove this. This will be automatically expanded. How does that work? Well, you need to add underscore underscore in order to link it to the report and also name it weather so that Excel links the chart data to the sheet. That's it. Now we need to find the storage space for the chart. We said in our application that it's going to be in the app data directory. So we need to find this directory. That is something you just have to find out by looking at the Explorer where your project is stored. Right click the project and then open folder in File Explorer. Then we can copy the path, change over to Excel, File, Save As, and then we say Browse, insert the directory, and here we can create the app data directory, and we call it, what did we call it? Let's look it up to be certain that we use the correct file name, temperature.xlsx, temperature.xlsx. It doesn't have to be a template with FlexCell. It's fine to use a normal Excel file, not a template file. In the FlexCell sense, it's still going to be a template and not a normal Excel sheet. And that's all you need to do in order to get things started. Final step on the code side is to get the vector image of the chart, right? So we need to assign a value to temp SVG. For that, we use the method xls.render, and then you see render object as SVG, and that is exactly what we're going to use. We're not going to use the index of the object, so we're going to pass -1. And then we use the name temperature chart, if you remember, temperature chart, to designate the chart. And we're just going to name it temperature as a title, and the description is going to be temperature in Celsius. Let's add a line feed here in Celsius and Fahrenheit, and the same thing. And finally, we need the encoding.utf-8. Of course, CodeInsight was a little bit misleading at first, so you can see right here, it's the object index, the object path, and then, which is the name that we use, and then the title, the description, and the encoding. So that's that. And right now, this is not being assigned to anything. So in order to assign it to the object that we want to assign it to, it's pretty simple because it returns a string. So it only is logical to write temp SVG equals that. And that's all we need to do. This will get us a string of the vector and the web browser, because we use markup string, will interpret it as a vector image. So let's see how this works. It compiles, that is always good. Going to fetch data, and we get invalid value for parameter. Well, I use something that is given in the documentation. Minus one is supposed to be specified if I specify the name. However, there is one little thing that I always forget, so I messed up intentionally, the at sign. Even though we do not have the at sign on the Excel side, this is definitely needed on the C# or Blazor code side. So you add the at here in front of the name, run it again, and at this point we have the chart below the table. This is how easy it is to include charts from Excel in your web pages without actually deploying Excel on that machine. It's all wrapped inside of .NET assemblies. Another nice feature using this kind of template design is that your application is running, but you can refresh the application and the template is being accessed over and over again. So actually making modifications to the template and also seeing different variants, because it's randomized values, don't get confused by that, but making changes to the Excel template can be seen right away. So we'll change over to Excel, and let's change the series to something what it really is. Select data, select the first one, which is, if you add it, you can actually see where it refers to B. B is the Fahrenheit value. So let's name this Fahrenheit, and the series 2 is actually Celsius. Okay, and then let's do another modification by adding a number format for the date, so it's actually shown as a date. You click the series right here, go to the bar symbol, number, not general, make it a date, and that's it. Save the template, go back to your browser and refresh the page, and that's all you need to do. You don't need to recompile your application because the template is being reloaded by your application. So this really loosens up the coupling between something that needs to be recompiled in order to make changes to the layout of your chart, for example. So you see we have Fahrenheit, Celsius, and the dates. And yet again, it's really easy and straightforward to include charts. And yet again, it's really easy and straightforward to add charts created by Flexcel to your web Blazor applications.